فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. Our Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he was born as an orphan. Our Prophet was born as an orphan. His father Abdullah, he died, and the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was in the womb of his mother. His mother was pregnant, and they say that his mother was pregnant 2 months. Al-Imam Hakim narrated in his Mustadrak, and he authenticated it as well, عن قيس بن مخرمة. قيس بن مخرمة said, توفي أبوه وأمه حبلى به, that his mother was pregnant when his father passed away. His mother was pregnant. Hafidh ibn Kathir said, والمقصود أن أمه حين حملت به صلى الله عليه وسلم توفي أبوه عبد الله. As soon as she became pregnant, her father Abdullah, his father Abdullah died, her husband Abdullah died. وهو حمل في بطن أمه, and she was still pregnant in her womb. على المشهور. ابن القيم said, واختلف في وفاة أبيه. He said, there came a discussion and a disagreement amongst the ulama, the death of the Prophet's father, Abdullah. هل توفي ورسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم حمل؟ Did Abdullah die whilst his mother was pregnant, or after his mother died, after his birth, the father died? There's a dispute amongst the ulama. Some scholars, they say, no, he was pregnant. She was pregnant, and the Prophet did not see out his own son. And there's another group of scholars who say, no, the child was born after that Abdullah died. These are the two opinions. Ibn al-Qayyim said, عَلَى قَوْلَيْنِ أَصَحُّهُمَا أَنَّهُ تُوفِيَ وَرَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَمَ حَمْلٌ. Two opinions, and the strongest of the two opinions is that his mother was pregnant when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his father, died. So he never saw his son. What shows that is that the Prophet's situation was like that. The statement in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Surah Al-Duha, أَلَمْ يَجِدْكَ يَتِيمًا فَأَوَى. Weren't you a person who was an orphan? So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was an orphan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sheltered and supported and aided him, alayhi salatu wa sallam. How old was Abdullah himself, how old was he when he died, the Prophet's father? How old was he? So how do you know? You read it from Sirah, Allahumma barik. But I told you guys this last week, didn't I say it? I said he was 25 when he got married. He was 25 when he got married. Are you with me? And his year, Abdullah just turned 25 when he got married. And she became pregnant, and he died, and he was still 25. Al-Waqidi said, هذا هو أثبت الأقاويل. That's the most solidified statement that Abdullah was 25. What did his father leave behind for him? The Prophet's father, when he died, what did he leave behind for him? The things that the Prophet's father left for him, the Prophet was خمسة من الإبل, 5 camels, وقطعة غنم, and a patch of camels, a portion, a very small, maybe 10 maximum, goats and sheep. وجارية حبشية اسمها بركة. And he left an Abyssinian slave girl. whose name was Baraka, and is who we will call Ummu Ayman. Ummu Ayman, radiallahu anha. Does anyone know Ummu Ayman? Ah. She married Zainab bin Haritha. He should marry Ummu Ayman. What was he? What's the mother? What was her son's name? Usama ibn Zayd and his mother. That's Usama's mother. Ummu Ayman is the what? She is the mother of Usama. And she died fi khilafati Uthman. She died when the khilaf of who? Uthman ibn Affan, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Radiallahu ta'ala anha. Our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's birth now we're going to go into. And I'm going to speak about his birth until the revelation came down on him, alayhi salatu wa salam. The Prophet ﷺ was born في نهار يوم الاثنين الثاني عشر من ربيع الأول. He was born in what month? ربيع الأول, the 12th. He was born daytime. The year he was born was عام الفيل, the year of the elephant. He صلى الله عليه وسلم was born. And he was born in the valley of في شعب بني هاشم بمكة. He was born in the valley of the people of بني هاشم in Mecca. Hafidh ibn Kathir rahimahullah, he said, هَذَا هُوَ الْمَشْهُورُ عِنْدَ الْجُمْهُورِ وَاللَّهُ عَلَمْ. The majority of the scholars, this is what's famous. So there are other views that say that the Prophet wasn't born then. Again, the Prophet was born on a Monday. He was born daytime. And he was born on the 12th of Rabi' al-Awwal. There are other views. There are other opinions that are out there that say other than that. But Ibn Kathir said, هَذَا هُوَ الْمَشْهُورُ عِنْدَ الْجُمْهُورِ. According to the majority of the scholars, this is it. Are we all together? جمهور العلماء, what's the opinion? That he was born what? He was born ربيع الأول. In the month of ربيع الأول. What year was he born? عام الفيل he was born. ولذلك الحديث صحيح مسلم من حديث أبي قتادة. The hadith of صحيح مسلم narrated from who? Abi Qatada, that the Prophet ﷺ was asked about the fasting of Monday. Su'ila an sawm yawm al-ithnain. He was asked about the fasting of Monday. And the Prophet said, Fihi wulidtu, I was born this day. Wa fihi unzila alayya. And the revelation was sent unto me then. On Monday I was born, and on Monday my revelation started to be sent on me. It was on a Monday it was done. The Prophet, he fasts. Some people say we'll celebrate the Prophet's birthday. We'll say do what the Prophet did, inshallah. What did he do? He fasted. Fast, inshallah ta'ala. Fast on Monday. Not on the day he was born, but on Monday. Fast on what? On Monday. Do those people fast on Mondays? See how shaitan has deceived. So fast on Monday, inshallah ta'ala. If you do that, no one's ever going to blame you, inshallah. No one's going to blame you. Ahmad narrated in his Musnad and Tirmidhi, بِسَنَدٍ حَسَنٍ عَنْ قَيْسِ بْنُ مَخْرَمَ, that قَيْسِ بْنُ مَخْرَمَ said, وُلِدْتُ أَنَا وَرَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ عَامُ الْفِيلَ. Me and the Prophet were born when? When were we born? The year of the elephant. Benefits that I extracted from the birth of the Prophet ﷺ on Aam al-Fil. Oh, this is the month of Rabi' al-Awwal. The Prophet was, what month did we say he was born? Rabi' al-Awwal. There were fawaid and benefits in the birth of the Prophet in Rabi' al-Awwal. Why? Number one, Rabi' al-Awwal is the month that's in the middle of all of these seasons. Sah? In the middle. Meaning in terms of exam of temperature and everything. And his legislations, alayhi salatu wasalam, wa shar'uhu a'dalu shara'i'. And the Prophet's legislation is the most just of legislations. It's in the middle. That's one benefit. The second one is spring is what? Spring. Everything springs. And the earth and the crops and the seeds, they spring out of the earth. The blessing of Allah, the crops, the fruits, they come out. And this was to say that there's going to come out for you all a prophet who's going to come out with real life, the revelation of Allah. That's going to give you guys life, and he's going to also be what? وَأَنَّهُ رَحْمَةٌ لِلْعَالَمِينَ. A mercy to what? All of mankind. Some signs have come apparent when the Prophet ﷺ was born. Are you with me, brothers? There are some signs that became apparent when the Prophet ﷺ was born. When his mother gave birth, some things happened. The first one is ظهور نور. Some light came from his mother that shone the palaces of Sham, our Prophet, when he was born. And is this authentic? Na'am. Bisanadin Hassan, with a sound chain of narration. Ahmad narrated in his Musnad, Ibn Hibban in his Sahih, Hakim in his Mustadrak, with a sound chain of narration. Irbad ibn Sariyah said, I heard the Prophet say, إِنِّي عِنْدَ اللَّهِ مَكْتُومٌ بِخَاتَمِ النَّبِيِّينَ. I is written for me. Nabi Allah, me. It's written for me. What's written for me? That I'm the final and I'm the seal of prophets. It's written for me. And he said, وَإِنَّ آدَمَ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامُ لَمُنْجَنْدِلٌ فِي طِينَتِهِ وَسَأُخْبِرُكُمْ بِأَوَّلِ ذَلِكَ دَعْوَةُ أَبِي إِبْرَاهِيمُ وَبِشَارَةُ أَخِي عِيسَى. Nabi Allah, Adam alayhi salatu wasalam is from dust. And I will inform you of the first thing of it. I am the dua Ibrahim made. The Prophet said, I am the dua Ibrahim made. Meaning, what did Ibrahim say? رَبَّنَا وَبْعَثْ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا مِّنْهُمْ يَتْلُ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِكَ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةَ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. So Nabi Allah Ibrahim made a dua. Oh, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent out on them a prophet who will read your verses unto them, who would educate them with the book, he will teach them wisdom, and he will also purify them. This is what? This is the dua Ibrahim made. Nabi Allah Muhammad said, I am the manifestation of that dua. Meaning, I is an acceptance of this dua. وَبِشَارَةُ أَخِي عِيسَى. And I am the glad tidings of what? عِيسَى بْنُ مَرْيَمْ. What did عِيسَى بْنُ مَرْيَمْ say? وَإِذْ قَالَ عِيسَى بْنُ مَرْيَمَ يَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ. عِيسَى بْنُ مَرْيَمْ said, O Bani Israel, إِنِّي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ إِلَيْكُمْ. I am a messenger from Allah. مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيَّ مِنَ التَّوْرَاةِ. And I am one who is affirming what's in Tawrat. وَمُبَشِّرًا بِرَسُولٍ. And I'm also giving you guys a glad tidings of a prophet. يَأْتِي who will come مِنْ بَعْدِ اسْمُهُ أَحْمَد. He's going to come and his name is Ahmed. فَلَمَّا جَاءَهُمْ. When he came بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ. When Nabi Allah Muhammad came with the clear evidences and proved that he was Ahmed. قَالُوا. They said, هَذَا سِحْرٌ مُبِينٌ. That this man Muhammad is a clear-cut magician. So I am the statement where Musa said, وَمُبَشِّرًا بِرَسُولِ يَأْتِي مِنْ بَعْدِ اسْمُهُ أَحْمَد. When Isa said, I'm giving you guys a glad tidings of a prophet that's going to come and his name is Ahmed, I'm that glad tidings. وَرُؤْيَا أُمِّي أَلَّتِي رَأَتْ حِينَ وَضَعَتْنِي أَنَّوْ خَرَجَ مِنْهَا نُورٌ أَضَاءَتْ لَهَا مِنْهُ قُصُورُ الشَّامِ. A dream my mother saw, that when she gave birth to me, that it came out from her a light. أضاءت لها منه قصور الشام. The palaces of Sham, it shone from it. Hakim narrated a different wording عن خالد بن معدان عن أصحاب رسول الله أنهم قالوا. The companions one day said to the Prophet of Allah, أخبرنا عن نفسك, tell us about yourself. People generally like to say that to you. Like, give us your biography, tell us about yourself. So they said to the Prophet, tell us about yourself. The Prophet said, دعوة أبي إبراهيم, I am the dua of Nabiullah Ibrahim. وَبُشْرَى عِيسَى, and I am the glad tidings of Isa. وَرَأَتْ أُمِّي حِينَ حَمَلَتْ, my mother saw when she gave birth. And no, خَرَجَ مِنْهَا نُورٌ, that light came out from her. أَضَاءَتْ لَهُ بُصْرَى وَبُصْرَى مِنْ أَرْضِ الشَّامِ, that it shone Busra, and Busra is a land in Sham. So this is something Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave to the Prophet. Ibn Kathir, he brought a benefit from this hadith. Ibn Kathir rahimahullah, he brought a powerful benefit from this hadith in his book Al-Bidayah wal-Nihaya. He said, وَتَخْصِيصُ الشَّامِ. Why did the Prophet specifically say that it shone Sham? Why specifically Sham? Why specific to Sham? بِظُهُورِ نُورِ صلى الله عليه وسلم إِشَارَةً. This is trying to establish and to bring to your attentions إِلَى اسْتِقْرَارِ دِينِهِ وَثُبُوتِهِ بِبِلَادِ الشَّامِ, that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم's religion is going to be rooted and is going to be grounded in Sham. وَلِهَذَا تَقُولُ الشَّامُ, and because of that, Sham is going to be فِي آخِرِ الزَّمَانِ, before the hour strikes, Sham is going to be what? مَعْقِلًا لِلْإِسْلَامِ وَأَهْلِهِ. It's going to be a hub for Islam and its people. وَبِهَا يَنْزِلُ عِيسَى بْنُ مَرْيَمُ, عِيسَى بْنُ مَرْيَمُ is going to come down in Sham. إِذَا نَزَلَ بِدِمَشْقَ بِالْمِنَارَةِ الشَّرْقِيَةِ الْبَيْضَاءِ, he's going to come to the white minaret, عِيسَى بْنُ مَرْيَمُ. وَلِهَذَا جَاءَ فِي الصَّحِيحَيْنِ, and Ibn Kathir said, because of that, it has come in the hadith in Bukhari and Muslim, that the Prophet said, لا تزال طائفة من أمتي ظاهرين على الحق لا يضرهم من خذلهم ولا من خالفهم حتى يأتي أمر الله وهم كذلك. That there's going to remain, the word لا is a نفي, تزال is a نفي, لا means negation, تزال also means it has معنى النفي, a meaning of negation is in it. And the قاعدة according to the scholars is what? نفي نفي إثبات. Negation, negation brings affirmation. So here what Allah, the Prophet is saying is what? There's going to remain a group of people, min ummati, from my ummah, ظاهرين على الحق, who are clear upon haq. ظاهر here means apparent. لا يضرهم من خذلهم, it will not harm them, the one who deceives them. ولا من خالفهم, and the one who what? And the one who opposes them, حتى يأتي أمر الله, until Allah's affairs comes. وهم كذلك, and they are like this. This hadith, pay attention now. This hadith, it categorized the people into three. How many? Three. Another riwayah says, لا تزال طائفة من أمتي منصورين. صح؟ There's going to remain a group of my people who are victorious. So the first group are victorious. Ahl al-Nusra, the people who are going to be given victory. They're going to be given victory, number one. The second one is what? Mukhaddila. Mukhaddila are those who deceive the people of truth. How do they deceive them? The people of the truth say to them, stand here, inshallah ta'ala, we'll defend the truth, we'll defend the religion, and they move out of the way. And then the enemies come to them through it. Mukhaddila, they deceive them. And the third group is what? Mukhalifin, those who oppose them. Those who oppose the people of, the people of the victorious people. So those are one, those are the one. One, those are the three. You're either one of the two. You're either upon giving victory to the truth, or you're the Ahl Mukhaddila. Whenever the people of the truth are coming out, you pull the carpet on them. Or you are from the third group of people, which is the Bukhalifin, those who oppose them, and is not with them. Bukhari, when he said, now we want to know, who are the people who is victorious? Scholars differ. Who are the victorious ones here? Bukhari, rahimahullah, in a riwayah, he said, قال معاذ, معاذ said, هم بالشامي, they are the ones in Sham. They are what? The people of Sham, number one. Bukhari also mentioned in his Sahih that this ta'if, this group are who? Whom Ahlul Ilmi, they are the people of knowledge. And Imam Ahmed said, إِن لَمْ يَكُونُ أَهْلُ الْحَدِيثِ فَلَا أَدْرِي مَنْهُمْ. And Imam Ahmed said, if it's not the people of Hadith, I don't know who they are. So we have different statements, right? Bukhari is bringing from Mu'adh that he said it's Ahlul Sham. We have here Bukhari bringing us another statement, which is that هُمْ أَهْلُ الْعِلْمِ. We have an Imam Ahmed rahimahullah saying who? They are Ahlul Ahlul Hadithi. Ahmed went on to say, إِن لَمْ يَكُونُ أَهْلُ الْحَدِيثِ. If it's not the people of Hadith, فَلَا أَدْرِي مَنْهُمْ. I don't know who they are then. Nawawi reconciles all those views. He says, وَيُحْتَمَلُ أَنَّ هَذِهِ الطَّائِفَةِ مُفَرَّقَةِ بَيْنَ أَنْوَاعِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. He said, this group, it's not just one group. They're different types of people. They are all, one thing they come together is, they are what? They are victorious. But they are different. From them is, شُجْعَى الْمُقَاتِلُونَ. A people who are victorious in fighting against the enemies of Islam. وَمِنْهُمْ فُقَهَاء. Amongst them are jurists. وَمِنْهُمْ مُحَدِّثُونَ. There are amongst them people of hadith. وَمِنْهُمْ زُهَاد. Amongst them are those who are aesthetic. وَمِنْهُمْ from them are آمِرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَنَاهُونَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ. Those who are calling to the good and prohibiting the evil. وَمِنْهُمْ أَهْلُ أَنْوَاعٍ أُخَرٌ مِنَ الْخَيْرِ. And there are other types of good people in them. وَلَا يَلْزَمُ. And it is not necessary أن يكونوا مجتمعين, that they are all one group. It doesn't have to be that. بل قد يكونوا متفرقين في أقطار الأرض. I mean, they don't have to all be in one place. Some of them can be in Sham, some of them can be in this country, some of them can be there. So it's more generic than that. And what Imam al-Nawawi mentioned, هو الصواب الذي لا محيد عنه. It's the correct view. But does the hadith give us a benefit that there is some ulama who said these are the people of Sham? Are you with me? And this is what Ibn Kathir was trying to bring to light. Why the Prophet specifically mentioned that when the light came from his mother, it shone Sham, because the religion is going to be grounded in Sham. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honor the people of Sham, take them out of the trials and tribulation that they are going through. Another sign that happened when the Prophet was born. A star emerged. Ibn Ishaq, he narrated in his seerah with a sound chain of narration. And Hassan ibn Thabit, from who? Hassan ibn Thabit. That he said, Wallahi inni la gulamun yafa'atun ibn sab'in aw thamanin. I was a boy who was close to puberty, 7 or 8. A'qalu kulla ma sami'tu. Everything I heard, I would understand it. Meaning I was mature, I knew, I understood. Anything I heard, I would. إِذْ سَمِعْتُ يَهُودِيًا. He said, I heard a Jewish man. يَصْرَخُ بِأَعْلَى صَوْتِهِ عَلَى أُطُمٍ بِيَثْرِبَ. Pay attention to this. A Jew man, he went on a high building and he shouted. أُطُم is a what? بِنَاء مُرْتَفِع. It's a building which is high. A Jew man, he screamed on the top of his tongue. By the lungs. He said, and this is in Yathrib. Yathrib is where? Medina. He said, Ya ma'ashara Yahud, O Jews, hatta idha ijtama'u ilay. The Jews all came together. Qalu lahu, he said to them, Waylaka malak. They said to him, destruction be to you. What is it that you're bringing us here for right now? Qala, he said to them, Tala'a al-laylata najmu ahmada alladhi wulida bihi. The star of Ahmed came out today. Today the star of Ahmed has arose, it's been seen. Ibn Hisham mentions this in his seerah. And I said to you guys, bi sanadin hasanin. The sanad is sound. Also, another sign that happened when the Prophet ﷺ was born. The next one is وَقَعَ رَافِعَ رَأْسَهُ إِلَى السَّمَاءِ. He came out, Nabiullah Muhammad, whilst his head was facing towards the sama, high above. Ibn Hibban narrated in Sahih and Ibn Ishaq in his Sirah with a chain that's disconnected. An Amina bint Wahb, Umm al-Rasuli, the Prophet's mother, she said, when she spoke, ثُمَّ وَضَعَتْهُ, I gave birth to him, فَمَا وَقَعَ كَمَا يَقَعُ الصِّبْيَانُ, he didn't fall like children fall. How did the children fall? How did they come out first? Head out first. Children's heads come out first, صح? Or the legs, which one comes out first? Huh? Their heads come out first. The Prophet ﷺ was not like that. It wasn't like that, ﷺ. He came out with his head up, ﷺ, when he came out. His head wasn't facing down. But as we said, this one that Ibn Ishaq mentions in his seerah is munqata, is disconnected. And there are many other signs that people have mentioned that the Prophet ﷺ had, which are not authentic. We're now going to move on to speaking about the Prophet's circumcision, alayhi salatu wasalam. Our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam, as it's authentically transmitted, that his grandfather, Abdul Muttalib, who is the Prophet's grandfather, he circumcised him يوم سابعه على عادة العرب, on the seventh day according to the Arab tradition. Arab, they had a tradition, when the child is born for 7 days, they circumcise the child. Ibn Abdul Barr mentions in his Isti'ab, on the authority of Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, that he said, إِنَّ عَبْدَ الْمُطَّلِبِ خَتَنَ النَّبِيَّ صلى الله عليه وسلم يوم سابعه وَجَعَلَ لَهُ مَأْدَبَةً. The Prophet ﷺ, his grandfather Abdul Muttalib, he circumcised him on what? On the seventh day, and he made for him a banquet. He made food. He cooked food for him. He cooked what? And that opinion Ibn Abdul Barr has taken, Kamaluddin Ibn Adib, and Ibn Abdul Barr and others have taken that opinion. Many others have taken that opinion. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As for the hadith that people narrate, that they mention, that Abu Nu'aym narrated in his Dala'il al-Nubuwa, which is a weak chain of narration, that Anas ibn Malik said, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, min karamati, from my karama means, what's the best translation for the word karama? Generosity, wouldn't be nice, yeah? Yeah. Unnatural, something that's not natural, that has happened to me. Ala Rabbi, meaning the generosity on my Lord, on me, like Allah being generous to me. So He gave me something He didn't give anyone else. That's what it means. So it's supernatural. Ala Rabbi, anni wulitu, that I was born makhtunan, I was born circumcised. Wa lam yara ahadun sawati, and no one ever saw my private part. This is weak. This is not authentic. The Prophet ﷺ was circumcised by his granddad Abdul Muttalib on the seventh day. Abdul Muttalib, when the Prophet ﷺ was born, he was very, very happy. His mother Amina, when she gave birth, she sent a message to Abdul Muttalib telling him the birth of his grandson. And Abdul Muttalib became very happy and he gave glad tidings. ولذلك Al-Abbas ibn Abdul Muttalib, when he was praising the Prophet, he said the following, وَأَنْتَ لَمَّا وُلِدْتَ أَشْرَقَتْ الْأَرْضُ وَضَاءَتْ بِنُورِ الْأُفُقِ فَنَحْنُ فِي ذَلِكَ الضِّيَاءِ وَفِي النُّورِ وَالسُّبُلِ الرَّشَادِ نَخْتَرِقُ. He said about the Prophet, أَنْتَ يُو نَبِيلَهِ مُحَمَّدْ لَمَّا وُلِدْتَ أَشْرَقَتْ, when you were born, it lit, the earth lit with the light that came from your mother. فَنَحْنُ وِي فِي ذَلِكَ الضِّيَاءِ, that light that came from your mother, we are still using that light to be guided to the path that pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet, as we said, he was circumcised on the seventh day and he was also given a name. The name he was given was Muhammad. There's a story behind how he was given that name, Muhammad, alayhi salatu wasalam. The story is that Imam Bayhaqi mentions in his Dala'il al-Nubuwah. As I said before, Abdul Muttalib, what did he do? Based on the Arab tradition, the seventh day he circumcised him. He did aqiqah for him, bikabshin, a big ram. And he also made a big banquet for the people, and he called him Muhammad. This name is unordinary. Muhammad is not a name the Arabs knew at that time. So the people of Quraysh were kind of amazed why he would call him Muhammad and why he would name him that name. They were what? They were amazed with that. So they asked Abdul Muttalib, لِمَا رَغِبْتَ بِهِ عَنْ أَسْمَاءِ أَهْلِ بَيْتِ. Why have you turned away from the name of his people? Why did you turn away from it? فَأَجَابَهُمْ. He responded, Abdul Muttalib responded by saying, أَرَدْتُ أَنْ يَحْمَدَهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى فِي السَّمَاءِ. I intended for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to praise him in the gathering of the people of the sama. وَخَلْقُهُ فِي الْأَرْضِ. And I also wanted the people to praise him on this earth. That was one story that Bayhaqi brings in his Dala'il al-Nubuwah. Some said there was another reason to it, another story, which is that Abdul Muttalib, he was traveling, and he traveled to Sham, and he traveled with three of his closest friends. And they went there for a business training. They went there to trade. فَبَيْنَمَهُمْ فِي الشَّامِ. Whilst they were in Sham, إِلْتَقَوْ بِرَاهِبٍ. They met a monk. They met a monk. فَسَأَلَهُمْ. He asked them, مِنْ أَيْنَ أَنْتُمْ. Where are you guys from? قَالُوا نَحْنُ مِنْ مَكَّةَ. They said, we're from Mecca. فَقَالَ لَهُمْ. He said to them, إِنَّ بِلَادَكُمْ. Your lands. سَيَخْرُجُ مِنْهَا نَبِيٌّ. A prophet is going to come out from it. فَسَأَلُوهُ مَسْمُ النَّبِيِّ. So they asked him, what is the name of this prophet then? They said, the monk said to them, إِسْمُهُ Muhammad. His name is going to be Muhammad. And Muhammad was not a name well known to the Arabs before that. So each of the four, Abdul Muttalib and his three friends, each and every one of them, they said, that in ruziqa bi mawludin sayusammihi Muhammadan. If Allah gives us a child, we're going to call it Muhammad. Everybody said that. Abdul Muttalib was old, so he couldn't have children. So the child came through who? It came through his son. The child came through his own son, Abdullah. Abdullah had a child, and he had that in his mind, so he named him Muhammad. As for the three, their names is Sufyan ibn Mujashi'in. He called his son Muhammad. The next one is Uhayha ibn Jallah. He called his son Muhammad as well. And the third one was Himran ibn Rabi'a. He also called his child Muhammad. All three of them. And the one Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala turned out to be the prophet was who? Nabiullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And as you know, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his name, as Hassan ibn Thabit, he said in a line of poetry when he was praising the Prophet, وَشَقَّ لَهُ مِنْ إِسْمِهِ لِيُجِلَّهُ فَذُو الْعَرْشِ مَحْمُودٌ وَهَذَا مُحَمَّدٌ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he brought Nabiullah Muhammad from his name. Meaning he became what his name is. Nabiullah Muhammad is a praised one. He's praised by Allah and he's praised by the angels, and he's praised by in the gathering of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rada'u al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet is nursing, and the breastfeeding that the Prophet was given. The first person who breastfed the Prophet ﷺ, who nursed him, was his mother Amina. Amina binti Wahb was the first person who breastfed the Prophet ﷺ. And she breastfed him for 3 days, according to one view. Another view says no, 7. And another view says 9. There are those opinions that the Prophet ﷺ was breastfed either 3, 7 or 9. ثُمَّ أَرْضَعَتْهُ ثُوَيْبَةً. Then After that, Thuwaybah took over the breastfeeding of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Who took over? Thuwaybah. Who was Thuwaybah? Right here. Who knows Thuwaybah? Other than you, who knows Thuwaybah? Nah. Has anyone ever heard of Thuwaybah? ما بقى شيء ثويبة إبراهيم هذا ما بقى شيء ثويبة وليها you never met her أيه ها yeah she was a slave girl of who أبو لهب she was أبو لهب slave girl are you there but what else was she what did she do for the prophet ها huh? yeah She breastfed the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. So when the mother of the Prophet breastfed for 9 or whatever opinion or 7 or even 3, who took over? Thuwaybah took over. Who was, remember a woman breastfeeds because she's got a child to breastfeed. So who was the child that she was breastfeeding? His name is called Masruh. Masruh and the Prophet are brothers from Rada'a. They're brothers from breastfeeding. Good. She breastfed him for days. This is all before Halimah al-Sa'diyah came. Thuwaybah, before she breastfed the Prophet ﷺ, who did she breastfeed? She breastfed somebody before she breastfed. I like anybody who's answering, inshallah, put your hand up, inshallah. Don't just shout out the answer. Hayya. That's Masruh was the same time as the Prophet. Hamza. Naam. Hamza was breastfed by Thuwaybah. Before she breastfed who? Before she breastfed the Prophet. So what's Hamza and the Prophet? They're ikhwan min al-rada'a. They're brothers from breastfeeding as well. It's his uncle and it's also his brother from breastfeeding. Who did she also breastfeed? After the Prophet. Before the Prophet was Hamza, who did she breastfeed after the Prophet? After the Prophet. Muhammad. Fatullah. Yeah? Abu Salama. She breastfed after the Prophet, Abu Salama ibn Asad al-Makhzumi. Abu Salama, whose name is Abdullah ibn al-Asad al-Makhzumi, he's from the Makhzumi tribe. So what are the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Abu Salama to each other? What are they to each other? They're ikhwan min al-rada'a. They're brothers from what? Something happened one day. The Prophet sallam was Hadith Bukhari collected in Sahih. Ummu Habiba bint Abi Sufyan. She came to the Prophet ﷺ. She said to the Prophet, إِنَّا مُحَدَّثُ We were being informed, we've been told, أَنَّكَ تُرِيدُ أَن تَنْكِحَ We have been told that you want to get married. Umm Habiba bint Abi Sufyan, she came to the Prophet and she said that we have been informed, we've been told that you're looking to get married, O Messenger of Allah. And what we've been told is that you want to get married to Turidu and Tankiha bint Abi Salama. Abi Salama's daughter is one who you want to marry. The Prophet said, Binti Ummi Salama, the daughter of Ummu Salama, Ummu Habiba binti Abi Sufyan, she said, Na'am, yes, O Messenger of Allah. Qala, the Prophet said, Lo anna'a lam takun rabibati. في حجري ما حلت لي. If the daughter,
Are you gonna say if the daughter wasn't my sister from Rada'a, I would have married her.
Say that one more time. I'm very slow, so you have to say it very slow for me. If the daughter here.
If the daughter wasn't my sister from breastfeeding,
No breastfeeding. You're close. Allahumma. What's your name? Ahmed. Mashallah. No, it's close. You're very close. Allahumma barik. You're very, very close. If Ummu Salama's daughter, huh? Get rid of the word breastfeeding here. You're right, if she just wasn't my niece. In the sense where Rabiba means the woman you're married, her daughter who grew up in your hands and you took care of her, huh? You're not allowed to marry. If I marry a woman and she has a daughter, I met her and she's got a daughter, this daughter becomes like my daughter. I never can marry her because I had a relationship with her. So the Prophet said, the daughter of Ummu Salama, if it wasn't, if we dismiss the fact that she is Rabibati fi Hijri, that she's my, like my daughter, if we get rid of that, if we dismiss that, which is a factor why I can't marry her, then there's another factor again, which is mahallat li anna habnatu akhi min ar-raba'a. The second problem that we can't get rid of is that she is the daughter of what? My brother from breastfeeding. Who's he referring to? Abu Salam Abdullah ibn Asad al-Makhzumi. So there's two reasons why this statement that you're saying, Ummu Habiba binti Abi Sufyan, that it's incorrect, is that I can't marry this girl for two reasons. The first reason is her mother is my wife and she's my daughter. Are you with me? And the second one is her father is my brother from breastfeeding. I can't marry his daughter. It's a haram. Sah? And this issue of breastfeeding is very dangerous. Many people don't take it serious. Are you with me? If a woman breastfeeds a boy of somebody else, are you there? And she breastfeeds her own son, her own daughter, and they grow up, she can't say, oh, marry each other, I raised you both. No. Is there a adad, is there an amount to that breastfeeding or is there not? We're going to leave that for next week's discussion. Next week, we're going to talk about the issue of rada'a, breastfeeding, and the ahkam pertaining to it, and the rulings regarding it, inshallah ta'ala. We'll leave it for next week. We'll pause there for now, inshallah ta'ala. Anything I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaitan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليه